by scientists at NYU College of Dentistry and NYU Langone Medical Center of cognitively normal, healthy, community-residing elderly men and women, average age 61. In this study, the investigators showed, for the first time in humans, a link between periodontal disease and the accumulation of plaques in the brain. The scientists said periodontal disease was associated with plaque buildup in the same areas of the brain, similar to those of patients with memory impairment. Our results suggest that periodontal inflammation infection may increase the risk for brain amyloid deposition. I started consulting other top doctors I met regarding these studies. We all agreed that the gene is just a byproduct, a marker that confirms the likelihood of having memory issues, but it doesn't trigger them. It may sound strange when you first hear about it. A bacteria on the teeth causing memory loss? Actually, it makes a lot of sense. Why? Because each one of your teeth is connected to your brain through tiny nerves. The infection can travel from the tooth to the nose, to the eyes, and ultimately to the brain, causing it to swell up and produce more sticky plaque. This makes your thinking processes slower and makes it harder for your brain cells to retrieve memories. And the worst part is, no matter what your dentist tells you, not even the deepest cleaning treatments can reach and destroy these bacteria that are tirelessly lurking inside your mouth, even when your teeth seem fine. I'll tell you why in a minute. However, do you want to know a sure way that the bacteria is already in your system? Do this 3-second test first thing tomorrow morning when you wake up. Raise your hand to your nose and take a sniff. If you have bad breath, then the bacteria is clearly there, lurking, waiting, and ready to damage your brain cells. If you often get a metallic taste in your mouth as soon as you wake up, then you should take action immediately, because that means the bacteria is already affecting the nerves and making its way to your brain. But now, you may think, oh, but Carl, I go to the dentist for deep cleaning every 6 months. Here's the kicker. According to a study conducted by the University of Michigan, there are 20 billion bacteria in your mouth. These bacteria reproduce every 5 hours. If you go 24 hours without cleaning your teeth, and I'm going to show you the most efficient way to clean your teeth inside this presentation, those 20 billion become 100 billion. No dental or medical method can destroy the gum-eating bacteria. I know that hurts to hear, especially when you shill out hundreds of dollars for dental cleanings every few months. This is not something you're going to hear from your dentist, because they have no interest in you knowing this. Normally, doctors recommend brushing your teeth at least twice a day, flossing or going through dental scaling procedures to get rid of the bacteria and tartar. And here's where it all goes wrong. No matter how well you clean your teeth, at least 10% of the bacteria will remain hidden inside the gum pockets. And there's a ticking time bomb waiting to happen. If this bacteria was so powerful and dangerous, was there anything that could banish it? In the end, this could happen to anybody, our spouses, our parents, and grandparents. I couldn't risk seeing the love of my life become an empty shell who would forget when and if she needs to go to the toilet, and eventually forget basic functions like chewing her food. I could not afford to let anyone take this away from me. So after working alone as a wolf, I realized I needed someone who would understand and be there, at least to help me figure out how to go from here on out. So I decided to make some phone calls. In the end, I kept hearing one name, Dr. Jack Lane. You see, Dr. Jack was well known in his field because he set up the basis of good oral hygiene in half of the third world countries with his NGO. And what drew me to him was the fact that he accomplished that without expensive equipment. without a